To some of you, hex codes in RGB color may seem like a foreign language. But if you go below the fold, you'll realize they function quite simply. So how do they work? And how did we end up with them as development tools? Color codes communicate the precise levels of red, green, and blue that pixels display in order to produce any given color. RGB color codes use three numerals of up to three digits. The hexadecimal, or hex value, uses three pairs of characters preceded by a hash. In markup, you'll see RGB color codes written like this, and hex values like this. When we see a color digitally, it's a combination of red, green, and blue light transmitted from pixels on the screen. And depending on the intensity of each pixel, a different color can be rendered. With displays today capable of higher and higher resolutions, a truly staggering range of colors is available to web designers and developers. Hex colors are expressed as six-digit combinations of numbers and letters. These color codes are basically shorthand for RGB values. They serve the same function with a little bit of math conversion thrown in for good measure. Instead of letters, RGB color values use three sets of three numbers with a range between 0 and 255. For example, let's look at teal. Okay, that's too much teal. Let's look at our color teal, whose hex code is hash 61EAEA, and RGB color code is 97-237-234. These element values may appear different at first glance, but the color will be identical when added to your markup. But how do you look at the jumble of letters and numbers that is a hex value and recognize a color? It requires a little mental arithmetic. No TI-86 calculator necessary. To make them shorter, hex values substitute letters when a value reaches two digits, greater than 9, with A being 10. F, the highest value, is 15. Multiply the first character by 16, and the second by 1. Add the two totals together, and repeat this for each of the values for red, green, or blue. From there, it's straightforward recognizing how the colors combine. Dive into the CSS for an image with color overlay added, and you'll likely see something like this. The last value is the alpha channel, which represents opacity. A value of 0.0 is fully transparent, while 1.0 is fully opaque. Today, most browsers support markup using RGBA. So how did we end up with RGB color? But for that, we have to go back in time. The RGB color code dates back to the mid-1800s when red, green, and blue filters were used to produce the first color photos. The idea arrived thanks to the Young-Helmholtz theory of trichromatic color vision, developed by Thomas Young and Hermann von Helmholtz. Fast forward a couple of centuries, and the NCSA Mosaic and Netscape Navigator became the first browsers to render RGB color. In that era, designers were limited to a mere 256 web-safe colors. However, by the 2000s, that was dropped in favor of 24-bit true color, a direct ancestor of the 48-bit system that today can render more than 280 million colors.